Have you ever been annoyed at the selling photos for Lolita that are so tiny, like the stock photos, or not seeing the dress perfectly before you buying? Today I'm trying to help you buy stuff by showing them very well. Today I'm showing you everything that I have for sale in this video, and I'll try to show you many details and tell you all about it, and then you can DM me to reserve it and buy it from me. So first of all, I'm doing that because I'm lazy and I don't have time to list everything on List Market yet, so maybe I'll do that only with what left. And I have been selling these on my Instagram stories, but you can only see just one picture. And yeah, I think it's best if I can show you in detail everything that I'm selling. And of course, you can ask me measurements and everything and more details by DM, maybe DM me on Instagram or Facebook, because YouTube doesn't have DMs. Let's go. So first of all, I will tell you that my bust is 96 centimeter bust and my waist 83 centimeters. Also, my arm, I don't have it now, I don't remember, but let me also write it on screen what is my arm circumference, because sometimes the issue is here. So that it can help you when I will tell you this was too small for me, this was too big. Of course, I can always measure it for you in detail, but just so you know. Okay, so there's a bunch of dresses, some Taobao dresses, some Bodyline dresses, some brand dresses, accessories, and a lot of petticoats that are left over from the Lolita petticoat compare video with 15 different petticoats. So let me show all of that to you, and if you're interested in anything, just DM me about that. But there's no guarantee that everything will be still there by the time you watch this video. Also, I won't mention any prices here because I might change the price and everything, so maybe in the description there will be prices. I'm not sure how I will do that yet. This dress is from Bodyline. It's in size 2L, so too large. It's, first of all, it's not my colors anymore. My colors is very much mint and pink, as you can see. I liked it as a casual dress. It was very comfortable, but here it was too small for my arms, so I could not really lift it because here it was too small, so that was sad. But other than that, this dress is great. It has a very distinctive A-line shape that I used for the petticoat video. Now I don't need that anymore. Just bear in mind, there is one zip, I think. Yeah, there's a zip here, but it's non-shirt, no shearing in the back. So for me, it was great. The also shoulders was good, but just here, it was not the best. This dress is from King 11. I loved this print, but unfortunately also it's not my colors anymore. And yeah, I decided that I will let it go. It has one pocket. Yeah, only one pocket. There's a zip here. The straps are removable and adjustable. This is the latest design. You have partial shearing with some corset lacing. There are detachable waist ties. And this bow here is also detachable, and I have the head bow that goes with it, so I think that's perfect. It was really comfortable for my size. I'm really just selling it because I don't like these colors anymore and I want to focus my wardrobe more on tones that I wear. Mentioning that I think it was together, there was one super cute sheer over layer thing, like tiny over skirt, that I decided to keep for myself, so it's not included in this dress. There will be a set with the hand bow and the dress. Next, I have this dress from Cream Lollipop. I think it's a Taobao brand. It's very cute, it's very my colors. You can see I loved it. It was fitting me on the back because it has full shearing, detachable waist ties, and adjustable straps, but I noticed that the bust here is very, very short compared to this one. You can see it does fit plus size people because the waist is very low compared to here. See, like if I take it here, see how high the waist arrives. So my waist would be about here in the middle of my boobs, and I don't feel it's pretty on me and I don't feel it's very comfortable. So I decided to let it go because the cut is not doing too well for me, but it's very cute. It has cats on it. Very, very cute, cool fabric, good quality. I did not know this brand before, but yeah. I think it's a very plus size friendly, but not the cut plus size friendly, if that makes sense. This dress is a Lisa dress. It has a zip here and no pockets, but it's partial shearing and it's size 3. It's not even mentioned here, but it's the biggest size of Lisa. It actually fit me perfectly. It was very comfortable. Again, not my colors anymore, but it's a very cool casual dress. It's shorter. It would accommodate a petticoat, but it's maybe a little bit too short to be really called Lolita. But when I was doing video with a blouse underneath, it was really Lolita looking, but still it's more Himekaji than Lolita, but it's super cool here. It has a cute belt that is all in velvet and velvet buttons here. It's a very, very good quality dress, very cute, and it's very rare because in Japan you cannot get the different sizes, and this one was made for the European market and bigger. This dress I bought on Taobao. I think it's a strawberry witch dress, I'm not really sure. It has a zip here and partial shearing, but I had it altered, you can see here. I removed a lot because on the side it was way too big and floating here, and so I had to make it, have it altered, and even though after that I did not even wear it. And there's an issue with the lining is actually smaller than the dress itself and attached to it, and so it's a little bit weird, and I thought it would fall weird on me. And also this bow is very sad here, but the color is gorgeous, so if you're able to sew and you want to make it work, I think that you can do something cool with this dress. I will not sell it for a lot because it's a bit sad, but other than that it has cute details and I think it's a really cool dress. I think there's a belt with that maybe, so maybe I should check it. If you're interested, let me know and remind me of the belt. So that's sad because the fabric is gorgeous, but the cut is a bit weird. But if you want to just buy it and have fun with it and cut it and make it look better, this is the dress for you. Now I have something that is not Lolita, not Lolita, not Lolita, but I'm also selling it, so maybe you're interested in it. It's a maid costume in cotton and it should be steamed because it's terribly, terribly wrinkled. I think it would fit me. Yeah, it would still fit me. And it has a zip in the back. Here's the apron. It has also some pink on it. And the back of the apron is Velcro. The apron is cute. And this is cute. It's a bit short, but this is not Lolita. Don't buy it as a Lolita dress. This is a maid dress, and I think it's not the best quality. Usually the maid uniforms are really thicker. And I think when I opened the package, I did cut something. I don't find it now, but it's very possible that there is some hole somewhere, a tiny hole. So yeah, let me know if you're interested and I will investigate more. This I'm very disappointed because first on the picture it looked like mint and it's actually sacks. So I was a little bit sad, and also it's too small for me. I think it has several sizes and this is size large, but the size large is not working for me. Okay, so it's actually a parka with a hood and a zip in front, and it's a collab from Angelique Pretty and Disney. It's a Little Mermaid collab, so it has embroidered here Ariel, and I think that's it. Does it have a label somehow? Yeah, here it has a label that mentions Disney store, and it's very cool, but too small for me even though it's large. So maybe somebody a little bit less bustier and smaller arms than me would fit that. This is a cutsew from Summer Tales Boutique. It's mint, I love it. It's a different mint, it's a little bit more greenish than the dress before. And the problem here is that here it's very tight, even though it's the fabric is amazing. It's really like a super thick and cool fabric, a stretchy jersey fabric. But here, the way the cuffs are made, it's very stiff and not moving, and it was too tight on my arms, and again, not very comfortable when moving, but it did fit me well here. So if you're about my size but have smaller arms, maybe that's for you. It's so, so cute. I'm sad that I could not wear it more, unfortunately, because of this cuff problem. Here's the casual dress from Access Femmes. It's not meant to be Lolita, but it would accommodate a small petticoat. What I liked about that is that it's transparent here, and you can see this flower pattern transparently, and then there's the lining underneath. I did not actually wear it that much because the color is kind of my color, but not really my style, so I ended up not actually wearing it too much. And so yeah, I'm selling it. It was also fully shirt or like three-quarter shirt, but it would fit me, so it's a great dress, very plus size friendly. You can also adjust here the straps, you can make it so, so much longer, and so very cool dress. Access Femmes is very cheap. I will sell this dress also very cheap, so why not? It's not 100% Lolita, but it could be worn as Lolita. Another piece from Access Femmes, it's a skirt. It's a very cool skirt. It's so stretchy because it has so many, like all both sides are a shirt. I liked it very much actually. It was very nice, but again, it's not my colors anymore. It has very cute patterns with swans and crowns and feathers and castles. Yeah, it's a very, very cool dress. I think there's a little bit of, there's stains here and some pull threads. Let me know if you want close-ups of that, like, yeah, from this lace. I can send you closer pictures if you're interested in that. Again, it's not very expensive because it's not a brand, but Access Femmes, and it's very cute. This is a skirt that my friend Lynn made for me in a trade, and it's really not my colors anymore. It's way too big for me. Also, it was really, really too big, and I cannot, it falls on me. So I think that plus size Lolita that would love this color would be more happy with it than me. And I find it a shame to keep it in my wardrobe and never wear it. So I'm really into having the clothes actually circulate and go to people that would love them more than just hoarding and telling, oh, I have like 200 dresses, but I wear only 50 of them. At the moment, I actually bought more than I can afford. Let me just touch on that. So I don't use any of the money that I earn salary for, basically because I don't even earn money these days. Yay! So all the money that I use to spend for Lolita is me selling stuff that I own, either Lolita stuff or other things in my house that I sell. And so then I have a number of money that I can afford to use to buy Lolita. And at the moment, that number is negative because I bought stuff. You know how it is. Like, there's a reservation, you want something, and so this is now or never. And yeah, that money is negative. So I should really not buy more until I sell more. But you will help me, right? Help me get new homes to these cool stuff so that they can buy more stuff that I will wear, right? Okay, so this dress, I would be so happy if it goes to a good home. It's brown, and here it's ivory, and there's here some two navy bows, but only on the front, and on the back there's none. So if you don't like the navy bows, and also something super cool, you can just grab the lace here and the ribbons here and make it go shorter to have an effect of, I don't know how it's called, but having the dress a little bit lower or higher. That's really cool. And I would say it goes at least to 110, a lot. Like, yeah, even better. It's really, really huge. Okay, now let's go to petticoats that I want to sell. I debated a lot wanting to sell my Cream and Sugar petticoat because I just got it. And actually now I have at least two good fluffy petticoats that fit me, and this one is way too big. I have not released the video about the opening yet. Maybe I will have when you see that, so if in the case I will link them there. But there are three sizes, I think, and one size was not big enough to go through my hips, so the size one, and the size two, even the relaxed elastic was bigger than my hips. So it would definitely fall, and you can see how big this is unstretched. You can stretch it so much more. So it's really, really big, and I think it could definitely fit somebody that is way more plus size than me and that have difficulty finding a petticoat, because the quality is amazing. They have so many different fabrics. It's not scratchy. The tulle has every layer on top and the bottom. It's perfect. I think their creation of the petticoat is perfect, but the size is just not the right size for me. And also it has a drawstring that you can use to adjust. And in my case, I would have to tie it so much that all the weight of the petticoat would be just on one of the drawstrings, so like not on the big elastic, but just the string. So it was really not for me, and I paid a lot of money for that. So maybe I wore it two times. I think another plus size Lolita would be so happy to find a big, big petticoat that they could wear, and that is really full and a top, really top good quality petticoat. So I think it's better in another home, and I have now better petticoats that fit me without needing adjusting. I have this petticoat from Classical Puppet. It's pink. I think one of the things I said about this petticoat, all the following petticoats, you'll find them in the big compare video, so you can look up what I said specifically about each of them. I think this one, the lace is very long and peaking, but it's very cute and so soft. It's not the most poofiest petticoat, but it's a perfect everyday petticoat. It's a bit tight for me also, so consider that, but you'll have measurements and everything, I think, in the other video. If not, just message me and I can tell you. But I can tell you that it's too tight for me at 83 centimeter waist. Now there's this petticoat from Borderline. It's size, it doesn't say, is it one size only? I think I would fit in it, but still tight, but the waist is very good. It's a bit scratchy, but not that much, because the tulle is actually quite soft. But this kind of tulle petticoat might deflate after a while, but it has so much proof that it's an okay petticoat for now. Not the best recommendation, but look up everything. It's a gorgeous color though. I really like it. So yep, I have this petticoat from Borderline. And now I have tons of these petticoats from Borderline. Let me show you. They are not the best petticoats. I will sell them for super cheap. They exist in many sizes. This is M. They are very short, but maybe if you want something for the decora or under a shorter dress or skirt, why not? They're not really recommended for Lolita, honestly, because they're too not fluffy and too short. But this one, I think this one would fit me. This one is 2L, so that's amazing. I have this one, the red one is medium. I have another wine medium here, another one unboxed, and another blue in medium. Maybe they will be like $5 to $10 per petticoat, so you can stack them on or just use them. You can actually use them for if you have a mannequin. You don't care how many petticoats you have under, because it's not on you, so you can stack many. Maybe it would work, but also it's short, so I don't know. But if you want many of them, I can definitely do a good price for you. And same goes for these crappy Milano petticoats. This one, actually, I ripped open. There was a Velcro here, and I opened it, so now I can fit it. But actually, I think that the waist is actually good. This is not the worst part. Like before, those are a little bit longer, but the tulle is very scratchy, not fluffy enough, but that's perfect to put tons of them in a mannequin or something. I have another black one that is very, very also ripped here, but yeah, don't wear that with Lolita. Don't use that as a nice petticoat. Really look at my video with other good petticoats. But yeah, if you need very cheap crappy petticoat for something, why not help me get rid of them? That I'm not sure yet, but maybe you will sell it. Let me know if you're interested. So it's a bit tight here for me, and it's very, very A-line. And also I have some LED cords wrapped all around. I did not go through the process of removing it because it was cool to put LED under a dress, but I thought maybe I will reuse that, but in It was only a year ago. I did not see the need to remove it yet, but if you want the crinoline, maybe even with the LED light, let me know. And also, yeah, it's very tight for me and a bit long for Lolita, I think. So you can see also my video about that in the petticoat compare video. Okay, and now there's tons of random accessories that are Lolita, that are Lolliable or things like that. So let's see. This is a crappy top hat I think I bought on AliExpress. It's really light. It's almost like a fur child. It's really small also. And I have one brown feather on it. Not Lolita at all, but I thought I could show that to you. Those are shorts that I bought also on AliExpress, I think. And they're some kind plus size friendly, but just a little bit tight for me. And also very short. The both of them are shorts. Yep, if you're interested in that, let me know. Some tights from Miyagolare, I don't know. They're from Japan, my friend brought that to me, but they are too tight, too small. I don't remember how it was actually not fitting me, but they're too tight or too small and I cannot wear them. So also this color is very hard to coordinate because so many different colors, but I think it's a great tights, but not fitting my OTT suite pattern and my being plus size in Lolita. Those socks are off brand. I got them with a dress and they're kind of weird because they arrive mid calf or at least a lot under your knee. And usually Lolita socks are either ankle socks or like under the knee or most of the time over the knee, but these are just weird length, and that's a shame because they're so pretty. The pattern is very cute. It's mint and pink with bows and white lace pattern on top and everything, but just the length is weird. Speaking of socks, I have these Alice and the Parrot socks. They are still new with tag. I bought it secondhand at Onegaishi shop. I see now there's just a little bit of ripped here on the parrot print, but I have just put them over to see that they're actually too tight for me, I think. And also not my colors. I don't remember, were they big enough, but definitely not my style and color. It's too dull and not bright enough to work with my wardrobe, but they're gorgeous. The lace is gorgeous. It's a cotton lace, like bobbin lace, I don't remember who it is, with gold and it's not mint, it's actually more like a petrol blue and very dusty pink, and it's more ivory than white, but they're gorgeous. I have the label, the tag and everything. But yeah, now there's this angelic pretty head bow. It's a lavender and it's on the side. I think it's sewn in, you cannot move it. I see one tiny stain here, maybe can be removed. It has some boning, some wire. You can actually make the shape that you want and make the bow a different shape. I bought it because I did not have anything lavender and I thought that I would use it, but it's a very dusty lavender. Very light and actually doesn't match any of the shade of the lavender stuff that I have. So I'm actually never ever worn it or just once. So it's gorgeous. So if you have something that you want to wear it with, maybe send me the pictures and we can check the tone. We'll see. But it's very bluish lavender and not reddish lavender. This head bow, I bought it on Taobao. I don't really like the shape of it. So that's weird because it's unglued here. It was glued here like the other side, but here it's unglued and I don't know, it just doesn't fall well. It has some mint grosgrain and then some sheer ribbon on top. It's cute, but it doesn't really work for me, so I'm letting it go. I have this other head bow that I bought and it was supposed to go with a dress. This I think I bought on AliExpress, and this one you can actually move it. It's a bit sad looking. It's not really easy to make look good, I think, because it's not sewn actually. Sometimes it's sewn and you cannot move it, but now it's not sewn enough to look good, I feel. And it's huge and it has a print, but the print is very subtle. It has some, here's a bow, here's some kind of water jug or something. and some pearls in many different colors. And here this tiny booth and a fork and a spoon. So that's kind of cute, and the headband is also covered in that fabric. The fabric is soft and shiny, and not that shiny, but really cool. It's not fitting my style anymore. And same for this one, I also bought it on AliExpress, I think. It's a kind of bright blue, almost like royal blue, and it's the clip that I don't really like because it's not easy to work with. It's one of these clips. It has a rocking horse here on the side, like a charm. And it's a bit too bright blue to work with my navy stuff, but it was a cute shape, like a Alice bow, I think. But yeah, the tone is a bit too bright for my stuff. Other socks, they're not really Lolita socks. They're just over the knee socks that I bought in Japan, but it could be cool with punk Lolita maybe, or just as cool socks. Maybe they're just below the knee, I don't know. They don't seem that high, but they're way higher than the other ones that we had before. And they're dark pink, like fuchsia, hot pink, and black. Here are two clips that I bought at Onegaishi shop. I don't know if it's from them or not. And they're very cool because this is the alligator clip that I love. But the color, the shade of mint, it's of course mint and pink. But the shade is very bright mint, almost like neon mint, if that's something. And it doesn't match any mint on any of my dresses or blouses, so I have to let them go, but they're so pretty. It's grosgrain and it has some zigzag trim. Somebody mentioned the name and I forgot it already, and it has three pearls on each side sewn to it. So it's gorgeous, it's great quality, just the color doesn't fit me. Now I have three bows from Claire's. Those are the tiny bows from Claire's. Again, I don't know why I bought them because it doesn't match anything. So this one is really just plain neon pink, probably will be not that color on camera, but it's really neon pink. It's the tiny one. This one is just holographic, very cool. And this one is a little bit like, I would say, mermaidy thing in mint, but it's more like a light green than actually mint. It's actually a tone that doesn't work with my mint stuff. It's too green. So I've got these three. Of course, I can sell them separately. I forgot this one bow also from Claire's. It's a royal blue, really royal, and it's the tiny one, same as before, but also a little bit too bright for the navy blue that I usually wear. And now something that I crafted. I realized that I made that for a tutorial or something, and then I did an online one together, like a live one, and I made the exact same one to copy, and so I had two of these. So this one is very me, mint and pink, but I have another one almost similar, so I decided to sell this one. So yeah, and on the back it's a two-way clip, so you have a pin and a clip, so you can put it in your hair, on your dress, or even on a bag or anything, because it's, yep, some kind of a rosette that is multifunction. Something else that I made, I bought these flowers, and so I made this huge crown. It's really, really big, and it has some gold chains that come on your forehead. And my idea would be to maybe put some big pike to make a gothic pikey thing, but that never got the chance. So basically it's, the headband is very cool. It's a soft and some kind of silk on top of it, and the thing on the back I just cut and put with some glue so it doesn't hurt your head. So this is how it looks like. It is huge, yeah, compared to the flowers that I have now. This is huge, but I think you can do something else with that. It would be cool. This is a ring. You've seen me wear this ring that I made, maybe. It's a big, actually it was a bee, and it has a hole throughout. It's a big flower, plastic flower, rose, but this one is bright pink, almost like neon pink, and it's too bright for me, but you can see how big this is. It's very cool, just not my color. And this is a hair tie from 6% Doki Doki. I got it in the Lucky Pack. It looks a little bit like if it's a Hello Kitty bow. It's a heart in plastic, but it's a Ginnan pattern that is red and green, not really mint and pink. And this is bright pink, so this is neon pink, and the charm itself is more red. And yeah, it's an elastic tie, hair tie. Now I have a couple badges. This is one from Creme Brulee. It has a panda head. And this one is from Groovy Roo and it says pretty magical, and you have two fighting thing crossed. Now I have plenty of necklaces. So the first one, I think it was from Whimsy.kay, I'm not sure, a while ago. This is a lollipop that is a heart, like resin, glitter, heart bow on the lollipop stick. This one is a Pokemon, I don't remember right now the name, and it's the ice version, and it's so so cool, and it's also resin and glitter white with a chain, and there's a tiny blue wing here, very cute, and it has some flowers at the bottom, very very cute. Also all of these, yeah, I realize I'm not wearing that much, so I'm happy that they would go to a nicer home. This is a Hello Kitty one. That is a charm in plastic or resin or something, but yeah, I think, I don't know if it's an official one, probably not. And here you have some gem. And this is from 6% Dokidoki, also was in the Lucky Pack. It's silver, it has a lot of extra strappy beads that are pearls, big pearls, and the charm itself is a key that is a heart with smaller hearts in rhinestones in pink. And I have the tote bag that I got at VidCon. This is Glam, Damn Glam. And on the back it's Moore MUA Makeup Academy, cruelty free and vegan. And I bought a palette there, and they gave me this tote bag. I'm not using it, also very cheap or free with anything else, because I have too many tote bags already. So yeah, now I have this cat bag. One thing is that you cannot really adjust it, or you can either do small or, oh no, wait, no, no, there's a way to adjust it. There's something here to adjust it. So you can make it smaller if you want. It's a small handbag from, it says Divided. So it's H&M actually. And it's a cat face with embroidered cat eyes and nose. That's very cute. I don't know if you can see. I have this umbrella. It's more an umbrella than actually a parasol. And it's, yeah, I know that some people think it's, not a good idea to open umbrellas inside, but here, there was something, and it's actually not here anymore. So you have just a screw, but you can put anything in, or just you don't notice it. And it's light pink with black flowers, and the border is actually cut out to make some lace. It's very cute. And so you have the handle like that here in the light pink and the strap. Honestly, the thing looks like it's foldable also, but I don't know how to do that. A few last couple of things. We did, I think, a Wish trade thing, and this was a dog. Like, it looks like a fancy charm from a fancy brand or something, but yeah, it's just a dog like that. Maybe the charm is supposed to be on top, yeah, something like that. And it's really not my style, but if it is, you can have it for free if you pay for shipping. Or it's so flat it could go in an envelope, so free with anything else. Oh yeah, and there was this Wish t-shirt, also free with anything else if you have an idea of what you could do with that. I have this Kimi doll wallet, many place to store things, many straps. I think what annoyed me is that the thing for coins is actually not closing well, and there's a hole here, and my coins will keep falling. I don't know how small your coins are in your country, but in my country they would fall, and they would annoy me. But other than that, I was so happy with all the many places to put all my cards. It's not in a perfect shape, actually. It's really, I will sell for you, so very cheap, because it's not in the best shape, but I can give you more pictures if you want. And the last one, it's a front cover that I got for me. I think I got a couple and I wanted to customize, and I don't know why I did not, or I did the other one, I don't know. And it's for Apple i7 Plus. It's written, I think it's a iPhone 7 Plus. And it's the Sweet Chocolate Journey print on it, and that's it. And it's a good quality one, because it's the ones that I use to put my channel name and everything, and that I wear all the time on my phone. It never ever cracked my phone. It's super good quality, so I'm really happy about that. It's just that I don't have that phone anymore. And so yeah, this one will also be very cheap or even free. If you do have that phone, let me know if you're interested. So that was my secondhand sales. Like I said, so many things, tiny things that is not worth putting on Lace Market. Big things that take too long to sell on Lace Market. So if you're interested in anything, just DM me somewhere and I can also do a discount if you take several things, or we can figure it out. I just want to get rid of that and put a little bit more money in my Lolita fund so I can afford more dresses that fit my aesthetic and give a good home to these. I might do a video like that if you like, for other like stock that I have for Fluff Dory, or I used to have a retail place, so I had a lot of Taobao stuff that I bought, and I have bags, shoes, and also Taobao dresses that I was selling there that I have stock in my basement. So if you're interested in that, let me know, and I will also do another video like that, because I think it's good to be able to show you all the details of everything that I'm selling, more than just the stock photo that is that tiny, and that's a little bit sad. So go check out the description for the links, for the prices, everything, and if you have any question, DM me on Instagram or Facebook. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, everybody can be kawaii. Bye bye.